spare match, so we'll go as USF this time. Let's go into space as far as we can do, and let's get ready. Got more viewers now, so I'm a bit more amped. Let me just finish off my tea one moment. Let's do this. Hello there, and welcome to Strategic Zoomcast Live! I did the wrong emphasis there, let me try again. Hello and welcome to Strategic Zoomcast Live! That's better. I emphasised the right word. We've got Korean Army Biancone. They're both very admirable players. Level takers Biancone, by the way, if you want to know who he is. He's using a Smurf name here. If it's my opinion, I prefer to players to go by their most common names, but if you've entered the tournament already, by all means stick to what you know and go with that instead. Two engineers out. First one goes straight for the strategic cutoff on the same wall, making the barracks in the most famous place you can make it. And then that we just saw the pack destroy the barracks. You think he might, you know how Co works, psychological games. You might want to put it there instead, maybe. I don't know. Just my thoughts. Three engineers start, so he's going to have a very good capping ability in the early game. So let's go check out the Vermat player, see what this guy's up to. It's all about seeing how many pioneers he has, I guess. Two. Straight into Vermat quarter. Standard vanilla opening for Korean Army. Korean Army, by the way, who just lost his first game. So just like, looks like Moobot's not working. Sorry about that, T-I-M-L-O-R in chat there, looking for the brackets. So somebody kindly oblige him and send in the brackets his way. So yes, we're in the first game of second game now of Korean Army versus Biancone. Could put the scores up whilst I've got a moment, so just give me a second whilst I do this. My camera's gone off to some trees, seemingly. This is the joys of OBS. It's a free program versus XSplit, which is scary to me. I don't want to use it. You can't make me use it, and I never will. There you go. 1-0 to Biancone. First battle! Worker battle! Oh my god, who's going to win? The engineers are going to win. Do you know why? Because they made it to that yellow cover crater. So it was all about that battle there, and that's why they managed to do it. There you go. You've got Chaos, the man himself, the tournament organizer, posting his own brackets. DevM did indeed manage to come through. I'm happy to say that now after casting all three games earlier on. And now we're watching a very interesting series. Very similar position Korean Army finds himself in. No spoilers in chat, please. Korean Army lost his first game. He's now playing live, 100% live as we speak in observer mode, against his opponent, Biancone, who managed to beat him. So two legends lost their first game. So let's see if Biancone can make it to round two in this tournament. In Strategic Zoomcast. So it's very good. You can just, to be honest, you can just chill the fuck out. I'm just like chilling out now. I'm just leaning back. I'm not even sitting forward to cast because you don't need to with Strategic Zoomcast. You just hover over. I'm joking. But there was a lull in activity and I took advantage. Just had some barbed wire come up on the choke point and a tank trap here. So this is going to really condense the US play. I need to stop saying USF. It is the US and CoH1, not the USF. And he's just able to sit back now and control this high munitions point. And Vermats really prosper with munitions. You get a lot more mines down, a lot more Shreks on your Grenadiers, etc. Oh, nice flank by the engineers. They managed to come behind the MG42 there, seemingly. Benefit of being able to see over hedgerows. Elsewhere in the west, a pitched engagement between workers again. Nobody has the cover, because this is directional cover, so the pioneers aren't at a loss there, but they don't fancy it, seemingly. And they're right to. They're very right to, indeed. Rifles pushing in. They see the MG. They retreat softly away. There are two types of retreats that come to heroes. One is skillful, a soft retreat, and one is pants on head, I'm gonna die, hard retreat. Rifle staying behind the hedgerow. Doesn't want to duke out against these pioneers, seemingly, and there's a folks grenadier to back him up. Korean Army's playing very carefully. Lost that first game, and is in a very trepidatious position. Doesn't want to push too hard in this early game as Vermat, which possibly might mean Biancone can build up with his rifles, get into position and do some big monster flanks. Because if you do that as Vermat and you put yourself in condensed territory, you allow the rifles to surround you and then come in one go. That's the negative benefit, the disadvantage of not being aggressive. He is holding his own though, getting pioneers in position. Getting the Foch Grenadiers in position. This is a proper killing match. It's like a bloody knife fight out there. Dear God. Very unrealistic gunfight, it must be said.
We're losing a fuel sector.
MG42 doing good work in the center. And he's finally able, after winning the monkey knife fight, able to push out and get his own plus 10 fuel. Which now means, by the way, that Biancone is able to get a triage, which costs, I think, is it 10 fuel or something like that, in good spirits, because he can also tech grenades in good spirits, because he's got 40 fuel still in the bag, man. That's what the benefit of having all these fuel points, earn, duh, and for a long time, trois, in his, at his disposal. Great economy there from Biancone. However, the good thing about Wehrmacht, you can just get the Kriegsbarracks, get the pack, and stay competitive. You do need the fuel to get veterancy, of course, and it will limit you, but it's not a death knell if you don't have fuel control. You can survive. Thank you, Magnioli. You're keeping me updated with the stats. It is 20 fuel, 200 manpower for the Trios Center. I am a fairly decent caster. I do remember the meta, but I haven't played CoH1 for a long time, and I don't remember the intricacies, the small details, you know? It was the game I played for many years, though. Love this game, still do to this day, and that's why I always relish the opportunity to get back into casting it. I honestly do. Interesting engagements up north. We've got two engineers, both with flamethrowers. That pioneer does not stand a chance. Neg cover about to hit. Oh no, yellow cover, assuming. The BMW is firing. Two MGs on Longres. Very strong build on Longres because it's such an open map. Look at these long channels. But the grenade goes in. He's possibly going to steal it. Will the BMW be able to keep it? He's going to try and push him off the weapon, but he isn't able to do so. Second MG opens up. First grenade open up. And looks like Biancone's taken an authoritative lead here. But he can't pick up the weapon. He can't retreat in time. And the BMW has saved the day. Elsewhere, engineers pushing in. Very rare do you see the Southern Victory Point captain. We are indeed seeing that. Managed to save the day there. Very interesting. Bike possibly going down to Flamer Engineers. Needs to get the fuck out of there. I've had something very interesting posted. I know I'm meant to be casting, but this is a very casual cast. I don't, what is that image of? Sorry, I know I shouldn't be doing this, but I just can't help myself. I'm on my own. I'm a bit lonely. The guy in front, he uses overclass family sword that's been in war for many years. Oh, I've heard about him. Yeah, he's very famous. Something English, I believe his name, or something like that. He's mad bastard from the D-Day operations, yeah. He'd be good in that fight. I know what you're referring to now. Good reference. I like it. More. He's finally recapping his victory point. This rate will be taken Berlin. Good to see more people rolling into chat. Famous names, Uncle Doctor, etc. I know there's a lot of lurkers out there. Get active in chat. Tell us your thoughts on this game. Tell us your thoughts on the strategies being used. Give me stuff to say out loud, because I haven't got an analyst caster with me today. And I am sorely missing my usual cast partner, Stormless. But unfortunately, that guy only has a casual knowledge of CoH1. No 1v1 competitive knowledge. So he's a little bit scared of casting it, and I can understand that. It is a risky business. For example, me missing those counter snipes earlier, I got slaughtered in chat, and as you should do. Grenade coming in. Oh, another dead MG42, perhaps. Good retreat. Nice. I think Uncle Doctor's famous. I don't know why. I just do. I think I cast him once. Indeed. The bike's having to get out of dodge. He fears stickies, and he is right to, because they are teching. 251 half tracks out, going to give the everybody's laughing the fact that I said Uncle Doctor's famous. I just think he sounds famous. I don't know why. Maybe he did something once that made me remember him. Who knows? If I see any other people out there tonight, I will call them out, the people I recognise. I did cast those games of the Legends Never Die tournament last year as well, so I do remember names from then as well, I must say. So we got two levels of upgrade. Is that a croquet hammer? It's a croquet hammer! Somebody's playing croquet out there. There you go, we got multiple upgrades now. These rifles are a real force to be contended with. Interesting battle up here. There has been a mine laid there. He needs to get out of there because it could be triggered. Hashtag triggered. Another rifle building. He wants another platform. So he's going to get a fourth rifle out. And also he's getting his motor pole up. That's motor pool up. That's the advantage of having so much bloody fuel. There you go, fourth rifle now up. Just gonna check on Korean armies. He has indeed got four that further far for land. Up. So that's defensive doctrine. It's rare we see that as well. Well, not rare. It's Blitzkrieg's the most rare, and then defensive, and then everybody goes terror, seemingly. Somebody just said this game has basically become a company of snipers. I suppose you must have seen a sniper. I didn't register. There probably is one. To be honest, I'm not used to seeing that many snipers. It's just not. I don't even point them out sometimes. I'm just like, yeah, snipers, woo. More snipers, woo. Yeah, they do get a little bit stale at times. There have been ideas in tournaments to limit it to one sniper per team at a time. This game is indeed from 2006. It does indeed look like it could be from 2016, in my opinion. It's a beautiful game. Cutoff has not been taken. I know it's showing red, but the... Oh! Sticky goes in. Preparation. It destroys him just as the Greyhound hits the field as well in the north. But it's not a cutoff because the victory point, the central victory point, was taken. That's right, Woggy. This game is older than chess itself. It's famously created by the Chinese in by Lelik Studios. A little bit of casual racism for you there. Never goes amiss. Rifle's got a difficult retreat path through the MGs. Possibly going to get focused. Needs to get focused if he wants to get the squad wide. One more shot. There you go. And look at that retreat path, like a brown slug across the map. Liking that chat's becoming more active now. That's what we want to see. You can hear that Pepsi is in chat. He's famously a mustache purveyor. He likes to have a mustache. That's what he's famous for. Nothing else. He's never streamed Company of Heroes. He's never won any tournaments. He's just famous for, in 2011, having a mustache. Elsewhere, it looks like the entirety of the US is isolationist, very culturally topical and politically topical. They're building a wall, dammit, and they're staying in their own base. They're handing in their passports. Don't want to come out of the United States, seemingly, right now. Look at the map control coming out of Korean armies. Really starting to get the map back. Black's blondness. Would zooming out in during gameplay be considered cheating? Yes. There's more of that to come, by the way. I have been speaking to Relic. I have worked out that my strategic zoom mode is possibly usable in CoH1 competitive. But I'm not going to tell the code during this tournament, I guess. Or... with Screenshotter and Twitch, nobody's allowed to use the zooming out, basically. But yeah, there's a YouTube video coming out tomorrow that's going to show you how to use this mode, because I've had it for about a year now, over a year in fact, year and a half now, just to myself, so it's time to share. It's really scary to me that it's usable in competitive. For the Fatherland has been engaged. So he's practically Terminators now. It's an army of mechs. Like, you can't do anything against, and I often just say, if you're US, just leave them alone for a bit, come back later. Engineer's in a really shit position. He's dead for sure. And this looks likely to go to G3 at this position. Just had bars popped in the from the barracks, but look at this. Possibly gonna pick out any of these units? No, he's not got any squad wipes. Oh, nice! Ah. So that's a tale of two different things. On one side, he managed to squad wipe. On the other side, he lost his M8. So, yeah. It's not going that great. For a second, I thought he might get back into this, and then all of a sudden, it went very wrong indeed. We are losing contact with one of our sectors. And he's going straight for the strategic cutoff. Look at all that stuff back in base as well. So this map is just going to get swallowed up in red. Yep, that's right, Chaos. Throwing nades at Korean Army. The guy that made three-rifle nades popular in about 2012 in SNF. Yeah, Korean Army's famous for his nades, and it's always funny when nades get used against the person that's famous for them. Artillery support is now available. He cancelled the WSC. He's probably thinking, what the fuck am I going to do here? And he's right to be thinking that, because he's in a difficult position. This Pioneer's retreated down this path about 7 times so far. So yeah, it's not going well for him. It is going very well all of a sudden for Korean Army, who lost G1. No spoilers, please, in chat. I am serious about that, by the way. If it's an accident, you get a timeout. If it's serious and you're doing it for trolling purposes, you get banned. I'm very serious. I like to pretend that this is live. It makes me a better caster, and it makes the viewer's experience more interesting. Honestly, it does. Trust me on that one. What the hell is this engineer doing? Have you seen this little fuck? Sorry, I keep swearing. By the way, I know your mother might be watching, but yeah, this engineer's deep within enemy lines, possibly planting some mines, maybe. Who knows? Don't worry, Level Take, you're playing very well at the moment, and your multitasking abilities are fantastic. Not only are you microing an entire army, you're also in Twitch chat. It's amazing. You must be a woman, surely. No man could have this level of multitasking. I must be honest, as a caster, I find it easier to cast Longrus. It's a little bit easier because, I don't know, on Sturzdorf it's a little bit wider. Any map that's like this is a bit easier. Ooh, nice defensive artillery. If he'd stayed for a second longer, that would have been a dead rifle, but he has survived. I've got to say, though, Biancone slash Level Take's doing very well to stay in this.
Our fuel point is being taken by the enemy.
Nice from the 105. One more shot. Oh! Destroys that pack gunner there. It is recruable, though. No other howitzer shoots to come out. And you can very much sense that that howitzer's a little bit exposed. Usually, I must be honest, howitzer placement on Longer Skies around here. I know he knows he's up against defenses, so he doesn't have to worry about the V1, but seriously, look at the health! He's already got only 10% health remaining. This is terrible. One more Shrek shot required. He's in Wehrmacht territory, so he's got the buff from for the Fatherland. There you go, decrewed weapon almost destroyed. One more shot required from the pack. Oh, there you go. There's 450 manpower. Gone in the blink of an eye. Oh, look at the Wehrmacht position. Really putting the cosh down now. Panzer Shrek reobtained by the Faust Grenadier here, so possibly a Grenadier went down maybe. Did I miss it on camera? Too busy chilling out. Yeah, we know full well about the howitzer placement, Pepsi. He needs to learn a thing or two. Every time I ever watched you stream, when you used to stream, it was always around here to protect yourself from the V1. So yeah, it looks like we're going to a game 3 now. If anybody's got any messages for the commentary, that'll be going live on YouTube to be seen for the next 7 years. Now's your time to say something. Any famous players out there, I've got words for the tournament. How you think you're going to perform? It's now your time to chat some shit. I will give in it readouts live on air. Here we go, a bit of off-map artillery on this position. Has he seen it? He's not seen it. Oh, first shot goes in. Brutal. Base is under attack. Hundred and 130 people are apparently famous in chat, allegedly speaking. This is that barracks play that could get punished. I did call it out at the start of the game. In the previous game, Wehrmacht destroyed the barracks in that position. I wanted to see it further behind the hedgerow, in all honesty. Although he has got all the upgrades already, so as long as he keeps his rifles alive, he should be fine. And he'll get off map combat group later in the game, if he gets to that point. Oh, he's run into the poo-poo. The poo-poo police are out in force. Here come the Focus Grenadiers with the focus down on the retreat path, perhaps. Will he get him on retreat? Car 98's firing. Will the MG42? Oh, there you go. Very much got like a horse racing commentator there. Nagano and Solon have played. I could cast that later if you wanted, but I've been warned I shouldn't cast it, basically, was the story. So yeah, feel free to spoil that game if you like in chat. I'm not going to cast it because everybody told me not to. He's cancelled that weapon WSC twice now. Are you going to build it or not? Oh, Rangers have come out. The famous Rangers that are great manpower investments that don't waste your upkeep and your manpower income at all. I mean, they're good when you get Vet 3 and Tommies, but if they're anything less than Vet 3 and Tommies for Rangers, they're pretty shocking in all honesty. Very much a Shelt 3v3 hero unit, in my opinion. It's alright, Woggy. We are used to XCOM Reborn being savage, especially when he calls Nagano autistic quite famously for beating him. What was it, XCOM? On stream, I think it was a historic 10 times in a row, wasn't it? It was something like that, and anyway, we all remember watching it. It was fantastic viewing. Thank you for streaming. But yeah, there's a bit of a grudge match there between those two players. And Nagano is on form. That guy had a rip-roaring 2016. 2v2 competitive, 1v1 competitive, Common Heroes 2, Common Heroes 1. He was all over the bloody place. He was winning tournaments left, right and centre. And he even started to outclass his Russian compatriots from the Ruka CL clan, which I know is a CoH1 clan as well. Puma in position. In position to do some poo-pooing. Oh, look at this beastie unit. It's like something from a dystopian nightmare future vision. When I went to Bovington Tank Museum, I had a guided tour because I'm a nerd and I paid for it. Me and my dad both did. And I was the only guy on tour that was like, oh my god, the Puma! Holy fuck, it's a Puma! And everybody was like, yeah, it's an armored core. Wow. But there you go. WPGG, GGWP, called by both players. A tremendous amount of chivalry from both players, it has to be said. I'm going to lower my camera, I think, because I want to chill out a little bit more now. Getting a little bit more chilled out, sitting back a bit, you know. Hopefully you guys have a beer. I've drunk too much beer recently. I'm trying to lay off, to be honest. There we go. Get it central. So, this is the straw poll that we want you to engage in right now. Oh, so I know what Chaos would have voted for, but you've got a series to choose, a serious decision to make, and this is a life-defining decision. You're one of 130 people watching a 27-year-old accountant casting an RTS game on a Monday evening, and you, dear sir, on the European continent most likely have a very big decision, life-defining stuff. What game is going to be casted next? You've got Chaos versus Firefox, Nuzliwuwa versus Comaster, Hulk Smash versus KL3300, or Sultan is Back versus Random. Yeah, I can see the results in real time. I'm going to go into the Yahoo Mail thingy and pick out the replays. Try and do it in a way that I completely forget what's happened as well. There we go. I don't want to see what happened. Just want to download the reaps. Thank you. So I actually don't feel spoiled at the moment. That's a pretty good position to be in. Is that right? I don't understand this. I maybe clicked on the wrong one. Hang on a sec. Does Necron go by that name by any chance? Is that right? Because I don't want to get confused here. I don't want to pick the wrong replays, but a lot of people choose the wrong things at times. Choose the wrong names to go by. You go by your most famous name. You don't fuck around with Smurfs in a tournament because it confuses the crap out of everybody. Worst ever was Alias and Fireball back in the day. Is that even the same? It's Firefox in this case. For all I know, it could be the same guy, you know. that's what it's like, though, in this community. Like, you've got a famous name and you change it. What are you doing? You keep your name, regardless. Right, what are we doing here? For my saltiness there. Hang on a sec. Let me get back to our regularly scheduled programming. Get CoH1 back up. Have a look at these replays. See if I picked the right ones. Look at chat. See what people have been saying. Can I take off my shirt, please? I'm a bit out of shape at the moment, I must be honest. So no. I mean, I've lost weight, but I've also lost a lot of muscle mass, so I kind of look a bit concentration campy at the moment. I'm not, you know, it's not something you want to see, trust me on that one. Yeah, I picked the right ones, good. Let's get on with it, eh? Also, let me do this now whilst we're chilling out, so I feel a little bit more. I forgot to upload the bloody scores again. I might just delete the score, to be honest. I always forget to do it, so I may as well. How do I do this? This is the advantage, by the way. If you want to get into casting, get XSplit. Do not get OBS. The features in XSplit are a lot better. Firefox, probably with a 3 or some bollocks. Who knows? Chaos, put some spaces there to get him into the middle. I presume that's right. Let me have a look. Yeah, I'm not putting X's in. That's for girls. You can have Firefox and that's it. I'm sorry, mate. But yeah, let me just acquiesce a moment, refresh my casting brain, do some vocal exercises. Me, 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 me. The riflemen are flanking. The riflemen are flanking. He got away with a slither of health. By the way, slither of health, most famous cliche in casting history. I remember watching Shoutcast back, well, on audio back in the day, and that was the thing everybody kept saying, and they still say it to this day. It's because English guys tend to dominate the casting world, in my opinion, because with an English accent, most people can understand you. And if you speak properly, that is. Anyway, let's have a look. Let's get loaded. Locked and loaded. Oh shit. Your fault, Chaos. Do you know why this is your fault? Because I don't even know who won the third game between Korean Army and Thingy. I actually purposely tuned out. But the good thing about YouTube is I don't, all the mistakes that go on in between games, I completely cut them out. But we know what we've got ready. So after those games, I'll be able to jump straight in. But yeah, that was a bit embarrassing. Anyway, let's load back in. I need to do more cocaine. Jokes. But yes, I did accidentally forget there is, of course, a G3. And that's why I didn't have the bloody... You know the text thing I did when I changed the text? What it should have said all that time, it was actually right. I did do it right. Oh, I'm such a fucking idiot. What are the players again? Korean Army versus, what was his mate? I want to say Basler. Bacchione. I can't. Was it that? Oh, I can tell in a second. Yeah. Biancone E. Right, okay. Fair enough. I'm an idiot. Missed all those counter snipes in that DevM game, and now I'm here getting the bloody players, the bloody game wrong. Well caught though, Chaos. At least you're concentrating, if I'm not. So yeah, pretend that didn't happen. I'm a professional esports caster. This is an RTS game called Company of Heroes, and I'm going to cast it very well for you now. Hopefully. Message hide. Put in the cheat hacks. Oh, I love Senua. I have an affection for Senua that... is more than I like some people in my own family. Right, are you ready, gentlemen? Because I certainly am. Let's pick a side. Did we do Wehrmacht last time? I don't know if we did. We'll just go with Wehrmacht. It's fine. Don't worry about it.
You need any construction?
Hello there, and welcome to Strategic Zoomcast Live. I did the wrong inflection. I'm a perfectionist. Watch this. Hello there, and welcome to Strategic Zoomcast Live. You're watching Biancone's Wehrmacht. He's playing as from the west of Senua. He's up against the very, very famous Korean Army. These guys have just been duking it out on Longra for our viewing pleasure. They've just taken each other's scalps, to put it bluntly. Both US lost in G1 and G2 respectively, with a large amount of base destruction, it must be said. That's how much Wehrmacht dominated on Longra, but we're used to seeing that on Longra, in all honesty. It is what we're used to seeing. And that's what we've got right now. We've got a G3 decider ace game, everybody. That's right, an ace game.
Pioneer team,
Pioneer's expanding as you would expect. You gotta start here, go right, go left, and jump over the bridge. Gotta call it out again. There is no fixed positions on Semois. A little bit odd. Von Klug is in chat. I mean, a lot of CO2 personalities out there are CO1 fanboys at heart, because let's face it, we all started at this game at some level. This is the best RTS of all time, and that's why we love casting it to this day and love watching it to this day. Traditional stuff so far, non-traditional positions, but it is interesting. Of course, if you watch that DevM, if you watch that DevM deciding game earlier on against DD, he had two howitzers here that were lobbing shells all the way onto this bridgehead. And this bridgehead became basically a moonscape. It was like the bloody Apollo mission, seemingly. And his sniper was attempting to be Neil Armstrong and eventually got smashed by bar rifle fire. 32 nine-man sniper. Just to regale you with a story from times gone by. Von Klug with a very interesting comment there. I managed to be consistent and be shit at both CO1 and CO2. I thought that was one of your biggest, you know, that was your attitude to life, to be honest, mate. banter. Anyway, Pioneers trying to ponder around here. They notice that they're outmatched, though, and outgunned by the Sturmgeschützgun. Rifleman and the Engineer, more than a match for a two-man Pioneer MP40 team. Elsewhere, a lot of barbed wire coming down from the Folks Grenadiers, just trying to deny his opponent, Korean Army, from pushing into his sectors. Here we go then, the motorbike recon. It's on. They're looking around for their first target. Who's it going to be? Navigating the village of Semois. Momentarily got stuck in the mud there, but he's going to find his target. Who's he going to find? He finds a garrison! It's the garrison of the Engineers. They jump out of it. Don't want to mess around with that, the machine gun on the bike. Constant fire being applied. Pushing away the Engineers. Difficult position! Oh! How did they survive? Oh, there you go. The Folks Grenadiers were able to kill them. First blood goes to Biancone. Where the riflemen are again a little bit leery, starting to push out. Look at that unison volley charge there, nearly destroying the bike in one volley. Level Take is the more popular name of Viacone. It's his name in the community. Finished his little barbed wire project there. Just going to deny these haystacks, because you can't get past this ridge, so it's basically 9-3 haystacks in an engagement. You have to go all the way around the barbed wire to get there. Possibly going to see some mines very shortly around this area. Be very surprised if we don't, but the Pioneers and the Engineers are going to come to a four. It's a worker battle, ladies and gentlemen. Place your bets. Who's going to get behind cover first? Looks like the Engineers managed to get behind cover. Pioneers are going to go for the garrison, though. Will they get to the garrison? It's all about who gets to that door. Oh, it's a close one, and the Pioneers got it. Engineers in a difficult position. Bike zipping around, looking for its next target. It hasn't got any kills yet, needs to get healed. And here you go, there's the sharpshooter. He's coming onto the battlefield. Scoped Car 98 rifle, gonna be a Widowmaker. But not quite the arse for it, if you're an Overwatch fan. Bike doing good work against the rifles. Just giving them enough to know that they're outgunned by the Folks Grenadiers that were bringing up the rear. MG42 has been built. It's very odd to see this coming out this late. This is a Folks bike sniper MG build. Nowhere near traditional. Flamethrower has been upgraded. It's going to finally win this worker battle. So it's the return of the Pioneers. That's a very good mantra in the Mutnozzly. Oh! Engineers go down. Nice from Korean Army. Biancone possibly showing a little bit of signs of fatigue. Tiredness settling in, perhaps. Not gauging the engagements as he would perhaps like. He needs a second wind if he wants to stay in this against the Korean legend. sharpshooter's already up to 6 kills. Many more kills in his future, most likely. CoH1 is company of snipers. And look at this battlefield, this beautiful map. Again, another map that's so much better in CoH1 than it is in CoH2. And to be honest, for this map, I put it down to True Sight in CoH2 ruins this map. Because these buildings, you can usually see what's coming behind them with an MG as Wehrmacht, but in CoH2 you can't. So it's a massively allied favoured map. I'm a tournament organiser for both games in the series, and I would not even consider this in a tournament in CoH2. In CoH1 it'd be my tournament final deciding map. I love it that much. Lucky Stilett says the zooming's really annoying. It depends how you feel, Lucky. I mean, at the moment there aren't any engagements going on. So, to be honest, I can do whatever the fuck I want when there's no engagements going on, mate. It's not saltiness, it's just true. You can tell on the attack map where the engagements are, and if there's no one going on, you're happy to just do whatever you want. It's kind of a different approach to some casters, where they accidentally miss stuff and zoom in on things when they shouldn't, etc. But, you know, you have to have a good game sense for the game, and know when you can look away, etc. That's what it's about. Riflemen, they're not doing too great so far, it's got to be said. No veterancy as of yet, and we're 7 minutes in. Sometimes you would even get one bar on a single veterancy squad at this point. Gets in the church, managed to get in there. Going to keep these folks grenadiers busy. And, yeah, it's an interesting one. Korean army, I'd say, is in the ascendancy, though. He's had most of the control. He's in now in the Wehrmacht cube, as we like to call it. That's the Wehrmacht cube, but of course this is reverse position, so it's the US cube in this case. MG and sniper in tandem, doing enough to keep that rifle at bay. The church Christian going rifle are able to stick it out, however. Just had something built in base. Whirring away is the grenadier from the Kriegs barracks. Elsewhere in the US base, the motor pool's up, very early motor pool. We wanting to get the M8 out sooner rather than later. Sub 10 minute M8 be nice.
Let's find some Americana.
Let's find some Americana. Grenadier's now out. Sniper still opening up. He's now up to 9 kills. Getting to that territory where he begins to pay for himself. 13 kills and up, and he started to pay for himself. Every kill after that is manpower attrition. Question mark. Korean. Oh god, he's too busy typing in chat. Possible death coming in. Oh, there you go. He hit the neg cover on that road. It was an instant headshot from afar from this folks grenadier. Question marks being traded. I don't know what that question mark was about, to be honest. Neither does Biancone. Korean army starting to expand his horizons, starting to cap territories he didn't have before. M8 is now out, it's got its skirts on, it eats a Faust shot, but it's absolutely fine because of it. Don't have any packs on the field yet. Be looking to get a pack out second from Krieg's barracks. It would have been possibly good to see it out first. Maybe we'll be seeing a pan. Oh, nice there, great shot in. Devastating. Possibly a late triggered mine, perhaps, that was. Rifles going deep into enemy territories. Sniper all the while plugging away. Already up to 13 kills now. Manpower attrition going to start happening. There's the pack. Second built from the Kriegs barracks. Rifle getting pushed away on neg cover. M8's in big territory now. Up against the grenadiers, which have no natural counter until we get the Panzerschreck. Elsewhere up north. That's the capping we were talking about. Korean army's just starting to swallow up the map like a $10 hooker. And just for, who is it? That's my hater. Hang on a second, I've got somebody that hates the zoom. But yeah, to be honest, with strategic zoomcast, it isn't about zooming out as much as possible. I just do that when the lull in activity. But it is good to get about this level for a later game engagement. So when you start to see the tanks coming out, it allows you to see everything happening at once. Like a Blitzkrieg mode is the viewpoint you want to try and achieve if you're casting with these cheat mods on. That is regular mode, you can't see enough. That's about where you want to be. You can see about 40% more just doing that alone. That is the benefit of casting with this, and I assure you it is highly received from most people that watch it. I wouldn't be doing it otherwise. It's not just a mod con. Anyway, elsewhere we've got the Pioneers, Engineers rather. I'm used to Korean Army playing a lot of Wehrmacht today. Because of course we had two wins as Wehrmacht, and that was Korean Army's big win to keep him in this series earlier in the game. He's going to have to wait till he gets the cutters up so we can get through that barbed wire though, so we'll hang tight on that one. M8's getting into position. The Pax there uncloaks. 60% health remaining. Possibly a Panzerfaust coming in. Could be dangerous for this M8. Oh, just about manages to escape. Nice. Could have been enough to kill him if it wasn't for the skirts. Still waiting for those bloody engineers to cut the barbed wire. Come on, it shouldn't be hard. You bloody engineers. There we go, rifle starting to get back in the picture. Back in base, the M8's gone. Bike starting to survey the battlefield. Oh, nice there. Big grenade goes in from the Grenadiers. Pushes away that rifle for sure. Elsewhere, back in base. Do you have Krieg's barracks up yet? Not much veterancy coming in, just veterancy one. For the infantry, of course. Passive healing. Very potent ability. Now time to check on the army size. Only got the one Grenadier so far. Let's have a quick check on his opponent, Korean Army. That guy's looking at four rifles and an M8. Very standard stuff from him. Now then, place your bets, ladies and gentlemen. I genuinely don't know who won this. I did watch G1 and 2, I must admit, in stream. And then I left it purposely. I wanted to cast this so much tonight that I just said, right, I'm leaving Twitch. Nobody tell me who won. I genuinely don't know what happened. So to me now, this is betting territory. I'd love Biancone to win because he's not the bigger name. Korean Army was. I love a good underdog. I think we all do. More veterancies piling in now. Looks like we've got support weapon veterancy coming in for the MG. A little bit more suppression, if I recall it correctly. Rifles are starting to feel a little bit dangerous now, though. Do they have stickies yet? They're going to need stickies. Or are the rifles going to be enough to defeat the bicycle on its own? M8 doing some good work. 6 kills on the M8. Damaged engine on the bike. It wasn't able to get away from the church area. It got hung up on the corner. Sniper continuously opening up. 16 kills. There you go. Bike finally careers out of control. Shall we all just take a moment of silence to commemorate the bike? There you go. Bike commemorated. Love a good BMW motorcycle sidecar. Sniper sneaking away. Is he within unveiling distance? There he goes. Been unveiled. The rifle's aren't targeting as of yet, and the MG is now covering for him. Oh, that's a difficult retreat path. 3 men, not much health. They're going to have to run away, but the M8 decruised the MG, and the grenade goes off. Veterancy 1 comes in for the rifle, and this could be a stolen pack 38. Elsewhere in the north, worker battles, both with panhandles. Oh, nice mine goes off, killing a possible engineer there. I think. Yeah, possibly. Pack 38 retaken. M8's doing some good work. Ooh, big shot goes in. Needs to decrew it. He's still got the top gunner. Notice the top gunner. A lot of the time, that dies really soon. But in this situation, it stayed alive and was able to get the shots off it needed. Oh, here we go, though. Off map. Howitzer shoots. 6 shots of destruction. Needs to get that pattern. This in target. Hitting the river. Needs a big shot. Misses. Oh, but there you go. The Panzerschreck was able to get the last shot required on the M8. Very cool indeed. I am a perfectionist. I did just notice something I didn't like about my scene as I've made it. Hang on a sec. He now holds a fuel location. I don't like the opacity on that. I'm going to change it. That's how much of a perfectionist I am. It was a bit too stark. There you go. Anyway, back to the game. We're now 15 minutes in. 398 victory points to 410. Very close. Obviously, we've got terror, we've got infantry. It's boring as fuck. Just jokes, keep joking. But these commanders, rather, these doctrines are the ones we always end up seeing on Semwar, seemingly. It's just such an infantry doctrine map, you know? Howitzer shots are so useful against bridgeheads. And you'll notice that if we see the on-map howitzer ability, he'll just be able to barrage the bridgehead and keep his opponent penned in for large portions of the game. Von Aston has called it out. It is the wrong starting locations. I've pointed out that many times as well. It does actually put Wehrmacht at a distinct disadvantage because, well, anybody that has to come over the bridgehead's at a disadvantage, in my opinion. Although there is this bridge here, so it does kind of balance itself out. It's not actually that much of an unbalanced map, Semwar, in terms of the symmetry of it. That pack, so lucky to have escaped with its life. Elsewhere, some good work being done to branch back out for Biancone to retake his territory sectors. He's got the central victory point, the northern victory point. He's trying to readdress the balance of war here. And look at all these forces coming back onto the field. The US, and this is strategic zoomcast when it can be useful. You can see the strategical movements of the units. He's going to flank around here. He's got what he needs to be competitive. Puma, though. The big Sonderkampfwagen 234. I can't speak German. I won't try. Is in a very commanding position indeed. Very rare to see the 30 cal out. No, that's the stolen MG42. What am I on about? Of course, that's the sound of it anyway. I was about to say, you never see a 30 cal out. That'd be madness. I'm a bit of a moron. That's a bit moronic. Never mind. M8's in a good position, doing what M8's do well. That's harass MGs in garrisons. Oh, we just saw a big loss of a flamer there. Good shooting from the grenadiers before they had to retreat. Possible grenade. More damage put down. Elsewhere, we've got an engagement between the Volksgrenadiers. They're going to harass this fuel point. Then we've got the standoff. The Puma versus the M8. The Greyhound versus the Poo-Poo. I only call it the Poo-Poo because when I first started playing Company Heroes, I was against my flatmate. It was 2008. And he taught me Company Heroes by playing one versus one against me about 30 times. He made me go as US and he went as Wehrmacht and he just poo-pooed me to death. And he called them the Poo-Poo. And he said, he used to shout at me through the flat wall, "Here comes the Poo-Poo!" And I was like, "Oh no, please, Daddy, no!" It was brutal. There we go. We've got the sniper of Korean Army opening up. Two kills in. Three kills in and counting. But the Poo-Poo! The Poo-Poo, by the way, I'll start saying Puma. The Puma, by the way, has just uncovered it because it does have a slight unveiling aura. A little bit of an unknown fact for some Company Heroes noobs out there. The Puma can actually unveil snipers within a very, very short distance. And that's what just happened. Elsewhere, the Pioneer's just about to jump into action just as we focus on them, almost though they felt our eyes on them. Now decapping the munitions cut-off, I like to call it. Puma's marauding, getting cocky. This is Biancone getting in a very commanding position. The 57mm's doing good work against the Puma, though, keeping it at bay. Elsewhere, we've got engagements all over the bloody place. Everything's going on. Oh, sniper possibly going down. Couldn't manage to get the counter snipe, though. Another mine goes off, this time against the rifles. Elsewhere, we've got a pitched engagement between the pack and the grenadiers. Not the pack, the AT gun and the grenadiers, rather. We have again got, of course, terror, inspired assault, and, well, I think that's right side, isn't it, inspired assault? I do get a little bit confused at the time. I know Zeal's left side. As I say, I know what all the commanders do, but the actual tech tree, I forget it at times. Kill me. Also, keep in mind, they actually changed. I originally got into Company Heroes in about 2008, then I had a three-year lull, and I learnt everything then. Then I got back into it and they changed everything. I remember that, it really annoyed me. I kept trying to go Calliope and it was on the wrong side of the tech tree, I remember. Two engagements to keep an eye on here. We've got everything going on in this map. He's expanding in the east. Got the fuel harassment, continuous fuel harassment by Biancone. Oh, nice from the sniper, opening up. Doing good work. There's prop war for you, though. Try and keep an eye on this sniper. So that's the Wehrmacht sharpshooter. This is the US sharpshooter. Natural born enemies, they're a pond apart right now. But very soon they'll be coming into combat against each other. Oh, here comes the Nebelwerfer. Time to get some strategic zoom cast action on the go. This is the beauty of it, by the way. Oh, nice targeting against that bush. If you hate shrubberies, that is the Nebelwerfer for you. Grease guns versus MP40s. A tale as old as time. The pioneers do not fancy it. They have to lick their wounds and get behind cover. Oh, the Puma looking again for that sniper. Pushing away this rifleman, stopping it from capping. Elsewhere in the centre, it's all going unholy. Hell has been let loose. Got to be getting close to... Oh, we got snipes going on all over the place. Puma, by the way, destroyed that rifle. Korean army, what are you playing at? Not good there. Oh, the snipers are starting to get a bit closer to each other. But yeah, it was sloppy from KA. And very good from Biancone. Folks, Grenadiers outmatching the engineers massively, 5-2. Snipers starting to get a little bit closer now. Nebelwerfer coming back up. I can't get enough of this shot, I'm so sorry. Harassing where he thinks the sniper is, notice. That's what that's about. Also harassing the stolen MG42. He's going to have to keep this 57mm here, Korean Army, because that Puma has been harassing this medium fuel point hell of a lot there, the plus 10. He's not even been able to have it, and usually you're meant to keep that. And that's the, in my opinion, no offence to this the people playing this tournament, but there's a distinct lack of strategy compared to the heyday of coming here as one. You'd always see this bobbed wide off in CO1 back in the day. I haven't seen it wide off yet, so get back doing that because it does matter. Oh, what's this? Firestorm has been unleashed. Oh! Nearly destroyed. Yes, he got him. Couldn't escape the firestorm. Oh, the sniper's going to get bar fired. He's been unveiled. Will the Puma be able to protect him? Possibly not. Three-man squad remaining. Oh, he's going to lose his life because of it. How did he escape there? That's the advantage of ducking behind green cover on the retreat path. The retreat path does come into effect, and just even hitting green cover here, perhaps, maybe, just for that one moment, maybe enough to save his life. That's the fine lines of CO1. Yet again taking the fuel point. Biancone is playing an absolute stormer here. Really good stuff. There you go. Look at this amazing battlefield. What's this? What's this little... Oh, that's the Puma. For some reason, it a bit prejudiced. Oh, the snipers opening up against each other. Very interesting. Waiting for his target. Who's gonna show themselves? There you go. Possibly. Is he going to go for it? Snipe goes in. Will the Wehrmacht sniper try and... this look? No, he won't. There was another one backing him up as well, so very wise. Elsewhere, you got an engagement up here against the Pioneer. Puma, by the way, with another kill. Jesus Christ, this thing is a killing machine. 17 infantry kills. Very good indeed. Again, with the Nebelwerfer, this thing's getting really far up. What a game. And he's got the Stug. It temporarily goes invisible. A bug as old as some people are in chat, most likely. No spoilers in chat, please. We're casting this as though it's been played right now, even though if it was technically played like 3 weeks ago. Nobody cares. Don't ask to know who wins, please. Just watch it as though it's live. Just trust me on this one. It makes it more entertaining. But to be honest, you've got to say right now, just to annoy the person that doesn't like the Zoom, that the Biancone is massively winning right now. Very difficult for our good friend Korean Army to get back into this. He's trying to make a go of it in the center. It's probably not going to work. Stug with a kill against the garrison unit. Very rare to see that. Mine goes off against the rifleman. So little health on that squad. Barely any point keeping them in the field of battle. So surprised to see both of these snipers still in combat. Nibelverse going up to deny these guys even the possibility of getting into play. Again denying the fuel up north. Oh my god. He's even stopping him. Yeah, he can't even take the AT gun back. This is brutal play. And the Puma is just waiting. Yeah, it's true about the fog. It is true. Ah, shit, that doesn't work anymore, seemingly. Snipes going in. Not doing quite enough work to keep him off that fuel, though. It's just not happened. Can't even get the sticky off. Oh, the Puma's been brutal. 21 kills and counting. AT gun can't even make the kill. The Puma's having an absolute stormer here. Here he comes with an absolute brutal firestorm. Not quite in base. The Puma suicides itself. Destroyed engine, so it's still technically alive. It could even decrew this AT gun. And there he goes. He destroys the AT gun with the firestorm. It'd be so funny if this got the 5% bug. Oh no, it does die indeed. GG! I can't believe it. Korean Army goes out of the tournament in game one. What a turnaround, guys. Absolutely amazing stuff. I didn't expect it. Nobody else expected it. He has been known to play on a little bit as a bit of a... No, he isn't doing that. I have seen him... I think he did that once. I'm not sure. But yeah, this is very interesting indeed. I wasn't expecting that. We did have a straw poll. I got a little bit confused because of the straw poll and I went to the wrong game. I forgot to cast the decider. That's pretty retarded, I know, but that's me. Anyway, we've now got the game that we're going to write, and this is the results of the straw poll. Chaos versus Firefox, 13 votes to 8 Hulk Smash. That is